political commentator. Having been imprisoned by the Chinese government and subject to forced labor, he now lives and is out in New York. Ken.
Good evening, everyone. In tonight's discussion, talk about the influence of the East. Thinking the limits of time, I may not be able to discuss too much about other Asian countries. I will focus on the country that frequently comes to mind, the Red Empire of China, which is now the second largest economy and the newest superpower. In discussing the influence of China, a common misconception is that China leads the world. In fact, China doesn't even lead Asia. In the past 10 years or so, China's aggressively impassioned behavior set up antagonism with neighboring countries, attracting hostility from all sides and placing China in an isolated position. If we take expansionism as an influence, it will be blockaded by the US and other countries. In other words, this influence will not last long. Another common misconception is that China will replace the US in leading the world. Let's examine this more closely. After the US withdrew from the TPP, the Trans-Pacific Partnership, the other countries did not invite China to join. Much less did China turn to be the leader of TPP. The reason is very simple. China is infamous for not following the rules and for going back its own world. And China cannot lead the TPP's free trade regulations, the high threshold of TPP. Especially, in particular, China cannot fulfill the TPP's provisions on labor rights and intellectual property safeguards.
On that point,
yes.
One might argue that China is actually Japan, Tokyo College, and University. One might actually argue that China is demonstrating its leadership precisely through not following this TPP framework that's set up by developed countries and essentially allies of America, but rather by setting up their own initiatives, such as the Belt and Road Initiative, to include another set of countries, namely the developed country, the underdeveloped country and developing countries in the Middle East and also some of the African region, as well as Southeast Asia. So they're coming up with their own framework of international trade and cooperation rather than blindly following a developed framework.
Okay, good point. China now currently do have some economic capacity. The China set up in Asian infrastructure investment like AIB or created Belt and Road initiatives. It looks like China has some economic dominance. However, this economic dominance is not enough to change, to influence the regional political trend, much less rise to the global level. Why? I want to say the following. Okay. Another common conception is that China will replace, another misconception is that while the US is restoring free trade, China will lead free trade. However, one of the prerequisites of free trade is the flow, is the free flow of information. How other countries expect China when China closes off from free information? establishing the great firewall to isolate the Chinese people from the rest of the world is extreme isolationism. It's true, as I said, answer your question, the Belt and Road, what talks us about Belt and Road initiative. It wasn't not only Western countries have cold shoulder to Belt and Road initiatives. Even among countries closely related to China, like Pakistan, Nepal, and Myanmar, they rejected or canceled China funding hydropower plants or dam projects one by one. Why? The reason are because China's asking price is too high. Mostly, China is demanding 90% of the profit. Or because China's load condition is too harsh. Or because the projects would harm the environment. We can compare, Belt and Road Initiative with the Marshall Plan, which the US used to aid European countries after World War II. We can see the actual outcome of Marshall Plan was benefiting of many benefiting our countries. However, the China's Belt and Road Initiative mainly benefits China itself, especially the red elite in China. I want to tell you, in fact, the Belt and Road Initiative implied another layer of intention of the CCP, Chinese Communist Party, syndicate. The corrupt Chinese senior official and red elite hope to find a legal object in the international community for their enormous ear-gotten gains through the so-called overseas investment, a disguised form of money laundering. This may be the most brilliant and secretive money laundering in the world scheme today. America's leadership emerged as a part of natural process after the First and Second World Wars and the Cold War. As the victor of all three wars, America displayed the world not only the formidable hard power, but also, more crucial, the powerful soft power, the values of democracy, freedom, human rights, and the rule of law. So, America took the mission of defending the world peace and became the world leader by collective endorsement. What the American persists is exactly what China lacks. China's native ethic image not only instills trade with neighboring countries, but also stir hostility with China, closely related to China regions, even in China itself. Beijing has declared Taiwan is an integral part of China, but most Taiwanese do not identify with China. Hong Kong was a British colony, returned to China 21 years ago, but the people of Hong Kong continue to reject the Chinese system. In other words, the Chinese influence does not go beyond its borders, not even to Hong Kong, only to Tibet and Xinjiang under protest. In fact, the majority of Tibetan and Uyghurs do not identify with China. The China's influence, the so-called China's influence, cannot go out of the border, can only enjoy it within its border. Once it emerges into the outside world, it stayed on the edge level. Because of time, I have to speak something. As one of the protesters of 1989's democracy movement, I at the political prisoner of Chinese government, I have witnessed the tyranny and abuse of the CCP's rule, which is much more hideous than anyone else can imagine. In 29 years since the Tiananmen massacre, I have watched the CCP's dictatorship has intensified, not only in suppression within China, but also in expansion out of its borders. When people speak of the China threat, I can't help but say there's no China threat, only a CCP threat, a threat shared by Chinese people and the world alike. For China, I'm going to end, and the time is running out, I'm sorry. For China, being prosperous or powerful, this is not the first time, nor the last. In the history of thousands of years, there have been many times. However, because the political system has never been cheap, dictatorship, then dictatorship. So then, the power has never been constrained, finally resulting in unavoidable official corruption. So each time, a prosperous and powerful channel turned to be a cloud of smoke. Today's channel continuing to reject democracy and rule of law will certainly repeat the failure of history. At this time, so I ask you to join me in opposition of this motion, because there has no enough evidence to show the future belongs to the East. Thank you.